Hi everyone, it's Laura here from MakingCardsIsFun.com and welcome to another card making video tutorial. Today's video is part of a fun collaboration block hop from Trinity Stamps in Wow Embossing Powder. In this video, I'll be showing you how to color the succulents from the Let Love Grow stamp set from Trinity Stamps, and I'll also be showing you how to add lots of gloss and shimmer to your project. So let's get started. I'm starting out with the Let Love Grow stamp set from Trinity Stamps, and I'm positioning it on a piece of Nina Suller White cardstock. This is the 110-pound cardstock. I'm inking up the beautiful succulent arrangement with Memento Tuxedo Black ink, and then I'll color it with my Copic markers. First, I am using BVOO to add some shading, and then I am blending that out with BVOOOO. I also wanted to add some turquoise, and I am using three shades for that. I'm using BG13, BG32, and BG11. And this card came together quickly. The coloring didn't take long at all since I kept it really simple and very easy. I'm just using two or three colors max to add color to these images. Next, I'm using another shade of purple. This time I'm using like a violet color. So I'm using V05 and V01. I really love purple. But I honestly don't use it a lot in my cards. I think it's quite a tricky color to use on cards, but the succulent stamp sets really makes it easy because there are a bunch of purple succulents out there. I actually own some purple succulents, but they're not that easy to maintain since they require a lot of sunlight, and we usually don't really have a lot of sunlight here in Belgium. So those purple succulents just turn green or like a pale green after a while. So anyway, moving on to this coloring. For the green succulents, I only used two shades. I used YG17 and YG25, I think. I don't remember, but you can always go back in the video. Then for these crystals, I'm using BG13, BG32, and BG11. And for the purple crystals, I used VO5 and VO1. After stamping this succulent piece, I didn't remove the stamp from my Misty tool, so it's still in the same place because I actually wanted to add some gloss to this image. First, I prepped my image with some kitchen flour just to make sure that the embossing powder won't stick to the wet alcohol ink. And now I just inked up my succulents arrangement with the Wow Ultra Sticky and Slow Drying ink pad. Then I'm sprinkling on the clear gloss embossing powder from Wow, and then I can heat set this, and this will give a beautiful gloss to your image. I recommend to heat emboss your images after coloring them with the alcohol markers, since it's just faster to color them without the embossing powder on there already. It just makes the blending so much easier and faster. Next, I'm stamping a sentiment from the Let Love Grow stamp set from Trinity Stamps. I used my Misty tool, and as you can see, I just cleaned off my stamp, and then I am not moving it since I'll be stamping on top of it with my Wow Ultra Sticky Pad to heat emboss it with the clear gloss embossing powder to add some extra shine. I also went ahead and positioned the bloom greeting from the sentiment, from the stamp set, I mean, because I'll be using some embossing powder with that as well. So I'm stamping these two sentiments with the Wow Slow Drying Pad, and then I am sprinkling on the clear gloss embossing powder on the black sentiments, just using a brush to wipe away any excess powder. And then for the bloom sentiments, I am using Primary Parma Violet Embossing Powder from WOW. This is a beautiful lavender color and it matches the other colors from the succulent arrangement perfectly. I'm just using my heat tool to heat emboss the powder, and then I'm using my Tonic Guillotine trimmer to trim down my piece to 4 inch by 5 1/4. Next, I am using this die from Spellbinders to add some pierced edges to this card front. This die cut set is actually discontinued, so fortunately I can't link to it, but there are similar die cut sets out there that you can use. You don't even have to do this, I just thought that the pierced edges gave a little fun extra touch to this card. I used some foam tape from Scotch to adhere my piece to a standard size note card, and here I am using my Tonic Nuvo Smooth Precision glue pen to adhere the shiny baubles and the crystallized unicorn tears from Trinity Stamps. This was the first time I used this glue pen from Tonic, and so far I really love it, and I'll be using it more in the future so I can share my final thoughts on this pen with you guys. Okay, so now that I adhered these beautiful and super sparkly crystals, it's time to add even more shimmer. Here I am using a Spectrum Noir Clear Gloss Shimmer Pen to add some sparkle to these succulents. And finally, I'm adding a coat of Tonic Nuvo Crystal Glaze for some extra shine and dimension. So that finishes up my card for this video. Thank you so much for stopping by. Make sure to subscribe to my YouTube channel and click that little bell icon to receive notifications whenever I post a new video. Also, make sure to check out my blog post for more information on the blog hub and the giveaway. I'll see you very soon. Bye bye!